Halloween, that's right. It's right around the corner. We're down here at the Newcastle Farmers Market. We're located on Route 13, and it's trick-or-treat time, and you're going to find a lot of tricks and a lot of treats right here in Newcastle Farmers Market, Greg. I mean, when it comes to it, anything and everything. But I love this because you've got a, you know, Halloween costume shop sitting right here in the middle of it at the market stage. You know, it's not a better place to shop than here.
No, this is something we started last year. One of our, actually our flea market vendor outside, one of our flea market vendors for years has sold Halloween costumes outside, you know, that people come and know about for years and years. And so he asked if he could do something in here, and we worked it out last year. It was like a big success, and you know, here you go. We have tons of costumes for kids, for adults, the great party favorites. He's going to be here all month of October, except for one weekend, Tim, where we're doing our free flu shot campaign, which is October 9th. So you can find him out here at the market stage, inside the market, and collect all your goodies for the Halloween.
I'm looking around.
Holiday.
I mean, you know, I didn't realize. I just saw the. I put the hat on, but they've got some of the best looking masks, you know, out there. I mean, just tremendous.
Yeah, there's some great masks. Yeah. He's known for the great masks out here. You know, and everyone's going to be doing something over the next month for Halloween. And, you know, it's a great holiday. I have little kids who, you know, love coming out here to the market because we have the Halloween candies in and, you know, at our candy stores out here and all these costumes. So, yeah, we're excited this time of year, Tim. Lots going on in October.
You can find this. You can find this right at the market stage. And you got a lot of other things. If we look around here at some of the different costumes and stuff that's available here, and the price is what we want to mention. You're going to find it cheaper here than less expensive here.
Oh, yeah, than any of those Halloween stores that pop up around town. Definitely come here first and see what he's got, because he's got a huge selection for, you know, kids, young adults, and adults, hats, masks, costumes. You know, Tim, this is the flu shot season. You know, everyone is pretty much now getting a flu shot somewhere, somehow, some way. And we offer free flu shots out here at the Newcastle Farmers Market every season. And we'll have our first clinic on October 9th from 10 to 3. And this is going to be an outdoor clinic this year, Tim. Out in the parking lot, we'll have tents set up. The Division of Public Health will be here administering free flu shots to ages 9 and up. That's going to be October 9th from 10 to 3. And then the next day, Christiana Care is coming back. This is the season where they come once a month and do free health screenings, free blood screenings. They do blood pressure screenings. And, you know, you can come out here and take advantage of that free clinic that Christiana Care offers. Of course, all of these things are on our website, these events, so that if you're not catching all the dates or times, you can go to NewcastleFarmersMarket.com and see when these things are happening out here. So the Halloween store is going to be here again after the flu shot weekend. And then, you know, Tim, every year we have the Korean War Vets come out here. They'll be here on the 17th, and they're a great group of guys that come out here every year. And that's another event that's happening out here at the market stage this month. Flu shots again on the 30th, and then we're going to have a big Halloween party out here. Halloween Day with Magic Bob doing free face painting. We're going to have a magic show, so a great way to spend the afternoon.
Trick-or-treating right here.
Yeah, right here at the market. We're going to do a trick-or-treat parade throughout the market, so really a fun event. We do it every year. It just happens to be, I think, that Halloween lands on a Saturday this year, so we're going to have Bob out here doing his show and doing the trick-or-treat stuff. So we're pumped up.
Let's talk about that, because that's you know, if you got kids out there that like to get dressed up, and you know, what a better place just to parade around and here in the market.
Oh, it's fun.
You do the parade at any particular time that you hold the
parade? Yeah, I think usually we do the parade right around the end of the face painting event, which is around 3 o'clock. So, you know, the kids kind of congregate around here, get the face painted, and then we do a little tour throughout the market. The vendors give out candy, and you know, it's fun. It's you know, it's great to see a huge group of kids kind of parading around.
Can they wear their costumes out here?
Oh yeah, we'll give away like prizes to kids with good costumes. You know, we'll have all sorts of fun stuff going out here that weekend. So
trick or treating here on Halloween night, Halloween day.
Yeah.
Get it started around 3 o'clock. Get out here.
The magic show starts at noon, and then we have face painting after that. So it's going to be a couple hour event, and then a little trick or treat parade, and You know, and then you can go home and rest up and get out on the streets that night. So lots of candy ahead for the kids.
Yeah, where are the kids out, you know, right here at the market. That's what I see. But when it comes to it, what a great way to entertain the kids on Halloween on a Saturday. They come out here, Magic Bob puts on a fantastic show.
Oh, yeah.
And then he's got the face paint and all that. So if you want to go trick-or-treat and want to get the face painted, you can do that here at the market. Then, you know, you're out on the streets that night because it doesn't wear off till you wash it off.
Yeah, so, you know, again, Newcastle Farmers Market. We can't stress enough how we you know have all our information on the website and contact information for all our vendors. So take advantage of that tool for you know figuring out what's going on out here. If you're looking for something to do with the kids or you know looking for something special or unique out here, you can't find it, give us a call.
Yeah, and we want to remind everybody too, Greg, if we can, hours of operation here at the Newcastle Farmers Market, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Friday and Saturday, 9 to 9, Sunday, 10 to 6. Want to remind you about the Dutch section. We're going to be visiting that here shortly. It's only open on Friday and Saturday, so if you want to come out and go through the Dutch section, it's not open on Sunday. You need to come out on Friday and Saturday and go through that. We'll tell you a lot more about that. As we make our way down through the market, there's so much we want to try to show you. Don't forget about the market stage. Halloween costumes are on sale right now, so come out and get them early, and the price is right. Necklaces, I mean, anything.
Tons of cool stuff, yeah.
All kinds of accessories. I mean, I love this.
Decorations, yeah. Costumes, props.
You know, just did a lot of things. So we got a lot more to show you right here at the market as we make our way through the Newcastle Farmers Market on Route 13. I tell you what, if you're into martial arts, you've got to check out the new expanded version. Where are we at, Greg?
Asian Treasures over here, Tim. You know, she had a small store for a long time, and something became available that was a little bigger, and so she relocated into this space, which is right around the corner from where she was, for those of you who may be looking for her and don't know where she went to. And so, yeah, this is a new location for her, and she's sort of expanded her line on martial arts training, you know, equipment.
And where? I mean, I noticed, you know, down through here, you know, if you're wondering where those folks get those outfits, you get them right here. I mean, that's where you get them at. I mean, anything and everything, depending on, I guess it depends on what style of martial arts you're taking, you know, from jiu-jitsu to, kung fu.
Karate, No, there's, you know, she's very knowledgeable, you know, she's been here for several years and they have a really big customer base, you know, and a lot of people look at a store like this and they're like, you know, they don't really know what to make of it as far as, you know, of course she has a huge selection of knives and you know, different, you know, collective items in that genre, if you will. And then of course she's got, you know, a huge following for people who take martial arts and then use, you know, and use the, you know, different, you know, equipment to train with, and she's got these sticks here.
You're the expert on this stuff.
I'm not exactly an expert by any stretch. I know these are used for training.
Well, you got a brown belt. I know that. I see you wearing that. But
I can run really fast. That's my weapon.
What are those?
These are, I guess these are bow sticks, and they use them to, you know, train for different sort of exercises agility exercises. But this is like something where people come from far away to get, because there's really not a lot of these kind of stores around. So she specializes in unique things that, you know, you simply just can't find, you know, on a typical store.
And what it teaches more than anything else, and I tell people, especially kids, young kids, discipline. I mean, and it really helps with the mind control and all that, and gets kids to focus.
There's karate stores all over America. You know, kids are, you know, it's a great way to get your kid involved in something that's, you know,
focus going and the development of a kid. So, and at the same time, learn how to protect themselves in today's world. I mean, you didn't really have to be able to do that. But so many different things in here. I mean, artwork, I mean, just like you mentioned earlier.
She's got some tea sets, a lot from China, and she's just starting to sell tea, fresh tea that you really can't find anywhere. You know, really cute, unique little gift items and, you know,
the artwork. The artwork is just spectacular. I mean, she's got it throughout the whole store here.
Yeah, her store before was just, she had a lot of stuff and it was kind of tight and claustrophobic. And, you know, she's, I think, thrilled to be have a bigger store and expand what she wanted to do before that she couldn't. So, Yeah, we're real happy about the new location.
If you want to go to the Orient, this is definitely
coming. Yeah, this is just another example of the diversity here at the market, Tim. Different kinds of stores that we have that are unique and that you can't find in other places. So
you mentioned knives. I just want to showcase some of these knives down through here because I like knives. Now they got throwing knives, they've got collecting knives, they've got you name it. You looking for a knife? If you can't find it here, you can't find it. You got one set? Oh, a comb knife. These are the ones that do not carry your comb on the airplane if you have one of these with you, because you're going to get in a lot of trouble. Pen knife.
This is actually a pen and a knife. So it's a real pen knife.
We'll call it a letter opener.
Well, this is a blue.
It's a letter opener, Tim. That's all that's for.
It in red, gold, silver, you name it.
Yeah, but as you look down through here, we got just different styles of knife, pocket knives. I mean,
pepper spray, the self-defense weapons. We have the utility knives. We have the rescue knives, which a lot of the police and.
Now you mentioned self-defense weapons. I'm looking at that. I thought it was a flashlight. But you have so many different things.
Sure. So let's go down here and look at some of these knives. Let's look at some of this, the rescue knives. So what you have here. This is for breaking glass. Like if you came upon an accident scene, you could break the side window to rescue someone. And a lot of the knives also have a seatbelt cutter in them. So a lot of the police and fire and rescue carry these type of knives.
Oh wow! So they're different knives for different, depending on what you need. And these folks here being the experts on it. I see machetes down there.
And here you see the seatbelt. So a lot of the rescue knives have both the glass breaker and the seatbelt cutter.
So a lot of police and firefighters come here to shop, Tim. I mean, we see them in the market every weekend, and they're here getting their sausage sandwich or pretzels, and then they know where they can go and get their boots shined over at Fast Feet, or come over here to get a knife for whatever occupation that they might be doing. It's great for camping gear, camping knives, hunting knives.
Let me see what he's got here.
We have a straight blade, which an old-fashioned barber would use.
Sure.
Some barbers today, but it's called a straight blade.
Tim, do you need a shave?
I see how you are just standing there with your hands shaking.
I've only had three cups of coffee today.
Yeah, I was going to say, you ain't shaving on my face. Yeah, in the old days, I guess they had to shave a balloon, I think it was, and not pop the balloon to qualify.
You have to know what you're doing. I mean, our barbershop here, Tim, they still have a straight razor guy over there.
Oh, yeah, he does.
So
I see him with the
leather. If you want it done, he'll do it for you.
Not me. I'm fine. I electric shave. So what are these up here? Shoes?
These are martial arts supplies. So we have uniforms, shoes, belts, gloves, pads. So it's
the gloves
for a variety of different martial arts.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then I see the big swords back here. I guess those are more for decorative?
Yeah, we have the decorative swords for collectors, and some of these are from actual movies. And we actually have some real combat-ready swords as well for the serious collector.
Yeah, well, I'm not that. And I see
the guys who practice and.
We have the mace, and again, these are more for display and for collectors. We don't recommend anyone walk around with these.
If I see somebody walk around with one, I'm out of here. But the expert Bruce Lee, of course, back there with the posters of those all throughout the store.
And so over here we have some full tang swords. So full tang meaning one piece of metal that the handmade. So they start with one piece of metal, and then they fashion the blade, and then also the handle.
I see them doing that on the iron makers thing, that they take bending iron and everything, where they make the whole sword. Yeah. But, Greg, if you're looking for it, you're going to find it here.
Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of surf fishermen that are, of course, Delaware is a huge surf fishing community, and, this is where these guys will come and get knives, to cut their bait and do stuff like that. Wow, look at that one.
Steel. So you can see this is a special type of process they use in making the sword. It's called red. This is Damascus, and they're very hard to find.
That's one of the. That's clearly one of the pricier, type of swords.
Right, right. But you got all kinds of different ones to check out. Ooh, I like that blue.
This is also a Damascus steel. We call it the blue one or the rainbow.
So I guess you're right, the blue one.
The blue one, it has that rainbow look to it. A lot of people say it looks like a rainbow when you change the color. Some of our knives also, but these are very hard to find and very special swords.
The experts use those. They're for demonstration.
Yeah, these are for. I mean, we would call them battle ready, but certainly it's for the fine collector, people who really appreciate well made swords.
Yeah, and these are all from.
reverse.
They're all
blade.
Imported from.
They're all imported, I guess.
From China.
These are all directly from China. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So this is what we call a reverse blade sword, and it's carbon steel, and so the blade is actually on the inside of the curve instead of the outside of the curve. So again, this is a difficult to find sword. Very special.
It might be difficult to find, but you know where to find them now.
You need to chop a pineapple really quick?
Yeah.
That's your tool.
There you go.
This one.
Ooh, pretty one, pretty.
This is a very special one. This is a red Damascus steel. So again, handmade, full tang, and you know, the serious collector definitely wanted to purchase this.
Oh, I'm telling you. So if you're out there and you're looking for the specialty knives,
hard
swords,
to stuff, yeah.
hard to find the collector items, the self-defense items, ready-made swords for ready for battle, you got those going?
Yeah, I mean, this is, I mean, didn't you just open a location in Philadelphia too?
Yes, another location in Philadelphia, South 4th Street.
Oh, wow.
4th and South Street, 529 South 4th Street.
Yeah, so, but nunchucks, I see those.
Yeah, we have the practice nunchucks with the foam, as well as the real nunchucks with the wood, and these come in different sizes for different size people.
Oh, wow. We're going to start you on the foam ones.
Yeah, I was going to say, I would take the
foam. Do you
want
to see what it feels like?
Yeah,
I bet you it doesn't hurt that.
Is the weight in the foam?
Let's get it out here, Tim.
It's relatively lightweight, but again, it's meant not to hurt. So.
Oh, yeah, that'll give you enough to
Remember we all tried these when we were kids and we all got hurt?
Oh,
the wooden ones?
Yeah.
Everybody like, yeah!
Now,
but this is
nice
fun
ones.
just to do something.
These are the professional ones. These are carved wood. So this is something that the serious user would purchase. So these are the real thing. Very, very, you know, good hardwood. And you can see the artistic carving. So these are dragon.
Those can very much hurt you, Tim, if you don't know what you're doing.
Yeah, I might have to come give me some
of
these.
You should get some.
Oh, I like that.
This is a cane sword. And this is pretty unique. And a lot of people like these. So it comes with a blade. It's a hidden blade. This particular one's not sharp, but if someone really wanted to sharpen it, could be. So, again, for the serious collector.
I love the cane. I mean, that is sharp looking. Is that all China once again?
From China directly, yes.
Yeah, gorgeous, gorgeous stuff. You can all find it right here. What's the name of it again, Greg?
This is Asian Treasures, right across from our Angel's Flower Shop, right by the Pretzel Factory. You'll find her.
Yeah, bracelets, you got it all. Come down here. Oh, I love these. Look at this. Ooh, I like that at all. It's all for you here at the Newcastle Farmers Market, Route 13. Remember, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Friday and Saturday, 9 to 9, Sunday, 10 to 6. And you're going to find so much more here at the Newcastle Farmers Market. And another thing here at the market, we want to talk about is service here at the market. And you've got plenty of service places, but one of the places you want to check out is Fast Feet. We talk about it a lot. If you need shoe repair, this is the place to come. Shoes polished. I knew I'd drop them off, get them polished, everything else.
Sure.
But October's Cancer Awareness Month, and they've got something very special going on here at Fast Feet.
Yeah, Breast Cancer Awareness Month, October. They're going to donate 10% of any proceeds if you come in and get pink soles put on your shoes, Tim. This is for women or men. It's something that they're doing this the whole month of October. You know, we always, you know, have a lot of events out here that, you know, are revolved around, you know,
cancer,
Christian cancer, and you know, the vendors that get involved in it. I mean, they really care and they really try to make a difference in the community. And you know, we give them, you know, as much credit as we can and try to let people know about the things that go on out here. But you know, come see Rachel over here.
Yeah, Rachel. This has got to be one of the best things I've ever seen. You come out here and get pink soles and heels.
Yes, we wanted to do something special for Breast Cancer Awareness Month. We want people to notice. They want to say, where did you get that? Why do you have pink heels? We want it to be an opening for awareness. Yeah.
And that's what it's about, awareness. And what a great way. If I see somebody walking down the street with pink soles, especially men, I'm going to tell men to get out here and have some pink soles put on your shoes to support that. I'm going to bring a couple pair I have. You
you got
to
do it.
Yeah, just to walk around in the month of October. What a great idea.
Well, we can make it stand out to where it's extremely noticeable, or we can make it subtle, where you only see pieces of it as you walk.
I don't think I'm a subtle kind of guy, you know.
Neither am I. So.
I want people, if I'm going to wear some pink soles, I want people to know about it. And you know, the nice thing about it is you're giving some of that proceeds for them doing it, you're giving that back.
Yeah, well, breast cancer is a horrible disease, and so many people are affected by it, and we want to help in some way to find a cure. What better way than, you know, doing what we love and taking what we love and donating a portion of it to research? Maybe that'll be the tipping thing. Maybe that'll help find a cure.
Right, and if you know, when you're talking about that, you know, what, give me an idea what a pair of soles and heels would cost for somebody.
Well, it depends. Ladies' shoes, if she wants to do just the heels, they run between $12 to $15 in the paint. If she wants to do the soles as well, that's another $25. We could paint the bottom if she wants. Men's shoes, if you want to do the pink heels, they run $20 for the pair. If you want to do the soles as well, that's another $25. We can paint the whole bottom pink. We can make it subtle. We can make it stand out.
Yeah, so I can come out here and just get my soles painted now.
If you wanted to, yeah, you could do that.
Yeah, well, yeah, there you go.
Cheaper than new shoes, Tim. That's why these guys are in business.
I've always, you know,
save money.
I'm going to have to go buy new shoes. I'm going to have to ask the young lady because I got a little split coming on one of my shoes. And I think because you guys do shoe repair. I mean,
everything.
From everything. So, you know, if you got stitches coming out, you can repair that as well.
Yeah. Stitches, stretching, gluing, soles, heels, shine. All kinds of stuff.
It's all here. They've been doing it for years. Rachel, thank you.
Shoe repair is more than you think.
Wait, stay there for a second.
Shoe repair is more than you think.
It's more than you think. Thank you so much, Rachel.
You're welcome.
Thank you for your support on the cancer awareness here.
You too. Help us support.
Yeah, it's all here for you at Fast Feet. So much more. But we want to remind everybody right now, if we can, about why people come out here each and every week. You're talking about the fruit and vegetable stands at both ends of the market here, and people come here every week to get their vegetables and fruits and all that. You can't go wrong when you're coming out here to the market for that. You can find I always tell people, if you're looking for stuff that they say on the cooking channel, put this in or put that in, you go to the grocery store, you're not going to be able to find it. You're going to be able to find it here at Newcastle Farmers Market because these guys pick up all. I mean, I was out there one day and I had a cactus. I'm thinking, what? But there's the people that cook with cactus. I mean, so it doesn't matter what you're looking for. You're going to be able to find it at the fruit and vegetable stands at both ends of the market. So definitely check that out for pricing and everything. Everybody raves about it. There's a lot big crowd there, but they keep it stocked up throughout the entire time that you're shopping, you know, the Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. But if you really want to come out and enjoy something, just walking into this area, Greg, I've gotten hungry all of a sudden. This is the Stouffer's Dutch section, if you would, and you come down through here. This is only open Friday and Saturday, 9 to 9, but not open on Sunday, but I'm starving.
I mean, it's packed in here for lunch, that's for sure. I mean, where else in the market do you see somebody walking around with an old vacuum cleaner part? I mean, vacuum cleaner repair, shoe repair. I mean, this place, it has it all, Tim. This is a favorite of the market out here. Everyone's kind of, this is a Friday lunch crowd going on, people stocking up for the weekend. I mean, this is a weekend thing for a lot of people. I mean, they can't wait till the market opens. I mean, there's guys waiting at that door at 9 o'clock to get in here and get that first ticket in the morning to get their meats.
Because you're talking about Stouffer's Meats, where as we walk down through here, I want people to know, I don't care what kind of meats you're looking for, you're going to be able to find it here. I mean, when they moved over here and opened this up, they expanded the meat section, but then they still needed to expand it more, so they even opened up a poultry section to separate from the regular. Now they got a poultry section
This is great for the city of Newcastle and for the state of Delaware. I mean, we've been around for over 60 years. The market's been around for over 60 years. And when the owner of the market and the owner of Stouffer's Meats got together and said, we need to add on a section and we need to add, you know, a few new shops to the market. You know, Byler's Barbecue's down here. You know, Stouffer's Sausage has been around for over 30 years now. We have a produce stand in here that does fresh squeezed juices, the bakery, and then, you know, we have the fresh donuts on the other side. I mean, so, you know, this is a real big attraction for people who not only locally, but, you know, from Philadelphia, from Pennsylvania, Maryland. I mean, you go outside in the parking lot and you look at all the license plate tags. They're from all over. And, you know,
it's
a
tourist attraction. It's a tourist attraction in itself. I mean, people come from all over because you have the flea market outside. A lot of folks enjoy that. But then when you get inside, it's a whole family experience. And I push that over and over again when I say that, family experience, because it is. I mean, the kids enjoy the market. Mine, every week, because we come out here on Saturday and we grab a bite to eat and we do the market. And the kids, that's the first thing. Are we going to the farmer's market this weekend? Yes, we're going to the Newcastle Farmer's Market. We go every Saturday. We come out here and grab a bite to eat and just stroll through the market. And, you know, and they try to talk me into spending more money.
Yeah. Well, everyone has their favorites out here. I mean, you know, those toast sausage sandwiches are, you know, probably one of the more popular lunch items in the area for people. Who, you know, you can go outside and you'll see a lot of the, you know, the state workers out there in their trucks popping in for lunch, and you know, police officers, firefighters, local, you know, kids who are getting out of school for the afternoon, come in here with their
Saturday
folks.
Saturday, Daps was telling me that he comes out here on Saturday or Sunday and does his shopping, and he says, I can't believe how much bigger the crowds are getting here at Newcastle Farmers Market.
Fridays more
people are coming out. And one of the reasons they're coming out is for this section that we're in. And one of the favorite parts of the Newcastle Farmers Market, even though he sets it all up and runs it, is the show and everything else. Believe it or not, this guy shops here every week as well, and that's Greg. And he loves the juicer. I mean, because, you know, when you come out here to get your own kind of juice, you create whatever you want, you know.
Oh, it's becoming pretty popular. I mean, they have a huge menu board where you can come in, you can get any kind of fresh squeezed juice you want. Hey, you know, a lot of people at home have juicers, but it's much harder to, you know, it's a kind of a pain to do it yourself. And
you got
to
clean
really,
this, do that.
Yeah, there's a lot to it, but, you know, and you have to buy the produce to do it. So, you know, this is like real quick and easy and real healthy and, you know, certainly one of the more popular growing stores out here at the market. You know, it's getting to be, you know, fall time out here. So, you know, you can see sort of the food and the produce sort of changes seasonally, locally, you know, things come in and, you know, we have the pantry over here that's got their Halloween candy going. It's never too early.
Oh yeah,
for that.
Well, that's what I want to talk about, because when we finish that, because I'm walking by, it's everybody's getting ready for this fall season. The pumpkin bread's coming out, you know,
and
that's all going to be here in Newcastle Farmers Market in the Dutch section. But this area right here, if you want specialized candy, come in here and talk to these folks. They actually make a lot of the candies right here on site. So, you know, if you want something special, they can do it for you.
Yeah, no, she dips pretty much anything that you can possibly imagine in chocolate. Bacon, pineapples, Oreo cookies, Twinkies, marshmallows, candy apples, you know. I don't know, there's just bananas. There's
s'mores.
Yeah, and then, you know, she's got ball candy, Asher's candy, and then she's got ball candy, food,
spices.
The lady
said there's bacon.
Bacon. I mentioned bacon.
Yeah, she likes that bacon.
Bacon.
It's all here for you, Newcastle Farmers Market, right here on Route 13, 273, come together, known as Harris Corner. You want to get out here and shop Friday and Saturday, 9 to 9, Sunday, 10 to 6. Remember, the Dutch section's only open Friday and Saturday. You don't want to miss all that. So much to show and do. We haven't even scratched the surface here at Newcastle Farmers Market. Greg, tell them what you tell them every week.
Get your flu shot out here Friday, October 9th. We'll be here for you 10 to 3. Visit NewcastleFarmersMarket.com. We'll see you at the market. Have a good week. The Newcastle Farmers Market has it all.